Shuklam Bharadharam Vishnum Shashivarnam Chaturbhujam Prasannavadanam Dhyayet Sarva Vignopashantaye Ramaya Ramabhadraya Ramachandraya Vedhase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sitaya Pataye Namaha Om. Dear friends, welcome to Valmiki Ramayana. We are seeing Sarga number 21 of Yuddha Kanda, in which Rama is slightly getting impatient. Rama, we have seen that Rama, he waited there for about 3 days and nights, and he was there praying to Samudra, and Samudra did not appear at all. So at that time, he says, just telling Rajaniti, if somebody is very humble and well-mannered, he is taken as a, he is mistaken as a weak person. So somebody who is really strong, but then he is humble and well-mannered, so he is just ticked off and he is not cared for. And people usually care for people, those who are very abrasive, very overbearing, and very haughty tempered. So such people, they get more respect from others. So that is what Rama was saying. What type of people are respected by generally by ordinary people? What type of men? Atma prashamsinam dushtam drushtam. Atma prashamsa. That is somebody who always says, yes, I am so great, I have done this, I can do this, I can do that, etc., etc. Then dushtam. Dushtam is naturally a person who is a very, very good man. He will not praise himself. Only usually some little bit of dushtatvam has to be there. Dushtam. And drushta. Drushta again is very, very overbearing and very aggressive. Viparidhavikam. Viparidhavikam means he is not happy to be stationed in one place. He is always moving here and there. What we call busy bee. He goes here and there and then comments on everybody, tries to boss over everybody. So such people. We find such people in our society also, in any place. Sarvatra utsrushta dandamcha. And a king who is always keeping his rod very high. Danda means punishment. He is always ready to punish people. Somebody who is always ready to punish people. So such people, they are respected. Sarvatra utsrushta dandamcha lokasya kruthe naram. So usually people respect such persons only. And nasamna shakyate kirtihi, nasamna shakyate yashaha. Then now, in fact, Rama is saying, we have been using this strategy called Sama. Sama, Dana, Beda, Danda. Since Sama, because Rama, we should not think that Rama is trying to use force on Samudra, etc., etc. Rama now is saying, he is fighting for Dharma. He is fighting for Dharma. He has to suppress evil. In order to suppress evil, he is approaching ocean god in a very, very dharmika manner. And we are also realizing, we are seeing an epic situation where Rama is avatara and Samudra is also a god, and Samudra also naturally has to support Rama. So that is the situation we have to visualize. We should not put 21st century questions, okay, how can Samudra get up, etc., etc. We are reading an epic, and we have to see things in that epic framework. In that epic framework, Rama is an avatara and this ocean is a god. And that ocean, and Rama is fighting for Dharma. When Rama is fighting for Dharma, naturally the other people also have to support him. That is the way we have to see it. Then nasamna shakyate kirtihi, nasamna shakyate yashaha. And by using this sama, yasha means fame. Fame is not possible. And praptum lakshmana lokesmin jayova ranamurdhani. If you are only utilizing, or if you are only employing or adopting sama, then you will not be successful. Then what has to do? Now I think I have to release my arrows. Unless I release my arrows, unless I become angry, and I release my arrows, this Samudra is not likely to listen. Then samaya hi samayuktam mamayam makaralayah. And this makaralayah means makara. Makara means crocodile. Makaralayam is the place for all crocodiles. That is Samudra. Makaralaya is another name for ocean. So this ocean god, he thinks I am a weak person. And asamartham vijanati, he thinks I am such a asamartha. Asamartha means incapable person. He is thinking that I am weak and incapable. And dikshamam idrushe jane. Dikshamam means idrushe jane. And towards this type of people, this patience is of no use. Dikshamam means patience is of no use. Shama is patience. Nadarsheti samname. And if this gentleman does not show up, does not give me some solution, then I am going to dry up the ocean with my arrows. Shoshayishya, samudram shoshayishyami. That means I will use my arrows and I will dry up the whole ocean so that vanaras can actually walk. Padhyam yantu plavangama. And they will go by foot. All these vanaras, they will just go by foot only. And there are some more slokas like that where Rama says, I will dry up the whole ocean, etc. Sampijya dhanur ghoram kampayitva senair jagat. Then he took his bow and arrows and he pulled that jaswana. Jya means that bow string. It made such a huge noise that the entire area reverberated with that. And kampayitva senaihi jagat, the whole world, when he shot some arrows, the whole world was shaken. Kampayitva, kampanam means shaking. The whole world shook when he released arrows. Mumocha vishikhan ugran, he released some vishikha. Vishikha means arrows. Ugran vishikhan, that is very powerful, terrible arrows he released. And when he released arrows, the entire sea became so turbulent and all the sea animals, all these water animals, they just came up. And then again, all these patalavasina, all the people, all those in the ocean and then the so-called nether regions, there are supposed to be Danavas and such people. So all those beings which are there underwater, they all got perturbed. And now, when Rama was trying to shoot some more arrows, Lakshmana intervened and Lakshmana says, oh, no, please don't do. He says, prakashamanam dhanurapramayam. Rama was trying to shoot some arrows. He just released a couple of arrows in the beginning. Then, meanwhile, Lakshmana just said, came in between, no, and then he actually caught hold of the hand of Rama. Mameti shoktva dhanur alalambe. Mameti shoktva, ma, in Sanskrit, ma means, no, don't do, that is called ma. Ma means nishedhartakam, it is called nishedhartakam. Mameti is ma, means no, stop it, so that way. Uktva dhanur alalambe, in fact, he actually caught hold of the dhanas. That means Lakshmana is having so much of liberty. We know that Lakshmana, he is actually a sort of conscience keeper for Rama. It is not as though Rama will go out of the, just shoots off and does some irregular things. But whenever Rama is slightly, he is rather overtaken. Rama, of course, jitakrodha means he has a person who has conquered anger. But sometimes he summons anger, krodham aharayamasa says Valmiki. That means he deliberately becomes angry and then he tries to do something. At that time, Lakshmana again tries to stop and then say, no, let us wait, etc. Now that is why he said, dhanur alalambe, he just caught the dhanas of Rama. Then meanwhile, even the gods, and Lakshmana also says, even without so much of effort, I think we can further plead and then we can bring down this samudra, this ocean god. And meanwhile, the rishis who were there in the sky, all those rishis, they also said, no, please don't do it, please don't shake up, because all these underworlds, which are so-called the nether worlds, they will also be shaken, you are going to disturb the whole nature. So they said, no, don't do that. Shabdah kutaha kashtamiti bruvadhihi maameti shoktva mahatasvarena ma. That means, no, don't do. All the rishis, they also said, Rama stopped for a while. Then, atho vacha raghusreshtaha sagaram darunam vachaha. We come to the next sarga, that is 22nd sarga. 22nd sarga, he is addressing that ocean god. Again, of course, Rama is not at cool down. He is still showing that anger only. I will dry up the entire ocean. Maya nihanasatvasya. Then he says, then let the vanaras go by foot. Mat karmakani srushtena saravashena sagara. O sagara, o ocean god. I will shoot my arrows and then dry up param tiram gamishyanti padbhireva plavangamaha. I will dry up the whole ocean and all the vanaras will just go by walk. And dhanavalaya santapa matto nama gamishyasi. Dhanavalaya, he is also saying, he is addressing Samudra as Dhanavalaya. Dhanavalaya means he is the abode of all the Dhanavas. We were seeing two words, Rakshasa and Dhanava. Even earlier, we got two words. Rakshasa is one and Dhanava is another. And this Ravana's wife, Mandodari, is said to be the daughter of Danu. That is one of the Dhanava chiefs. So, Rakshasas, probably they are said to be more cruel than these Dhanavas, though they also belong to the Asura category. So anyway, this Danavalaya means Samudra. So then Rama again, when this Samudra did not show up, Rama again takes this Brahmastra. He takes his Brahmastra and then he fixes on its bow. Brahmenastrena sanyojya brahmadanda nibham sharam. So he took out that sharam, a powerful arrow, and he recited this Brahmastra. We have seen this Brahmastra even earlier. So the sanyojya dhanushi sreshti vichakarsha mahabala, then he tried to pull it. Then at that time the whole world shook. There are a lot many shlokas about how the whole world shook and then how the nature got perturbed and then how the winds behaved, how the ocean behaved, etc., etc. And then the ocean actually retreated as a certain by about one yojana. Yojanam yati chakrama, that is that ocean. It rose in a very, very high tide and then about it went back about one yojana. Yojana means a couple of kilometers, let us say. A couple of kilometers back the ocean retreated and it turned into a human shape. And as a sort of human being, that Samudra appeared. Then, of course, Rama has not yet released. He is just holding it like that. Meanwhile, that ocean got shook. And then he just came up. A huge wave, the ocean retreated and the ocean came up. Then he appeared in a sort of human form. Tato madhyat samudrasya sagara swayam uthitaha. That sagara. Sagara is that ocean god. He just appeared. And there is a description of that ocean god, how when the ocean god stood up, all these aquatic animals, they also came up along with him all over the body. All these aquatic animals were there. And this ocean is also said to be a ratnakara. Ocean is said to be the place for all these gems and all types of precious things. So that ratnakara, he was also malyambaradhara. He was having so many garlands of these gems and whatnot. And also gem-studded clothes also, ratna malyambaradhara, ambara means cloth. So he was wearing clothes studded with all those gems, etc. And the crown of golden flowers, so he was wearing. There is a big description about him. And he now comes, he with a folded hand, abravit pranjalir vakyam raghavam sharapaninam. Rama was standing with that Brahmastra. And ocean god appears in front of him with a folded hands, and then he says, "O Rama, just understand my position. I have to observe the laws of nature, because there are these five elements in the entire universe. The entire universe is consisting of, broadly, we should not think about the Mendeleev's periodic table and then 130 elements and 140 elements, forget about it. We are now talking about broadly. Broadly means we see Prithivi, the hard matter, water, that is the fluid we see, then again fire we see, then air we see, and then again beyond air we see Akasha. That is what we say, Prithivi, Apaha, Teja, Vayu and Akasha. These are the five elements. So these five elements, they have got their own properties. Prithivi has to have its own property. Prithivi is something which is very heavy. And Gandhavati Prithivi, if you see Tarkashastra or something like that, if you see, then for every bhuta, what is the characteristic of a bhuta? Such things are mentioned. And water is something which is always flowing down, that is its nature. Then fire is something which just glows up and also burns the people. And again vayu is something which spreads out and moves everywhere. Akasha is something which is shining everywhere. So like that, these are the things which have to observe the laws of nature. And I can't go beyond the laws of nature. I have to follow the laws of nature. Then he says, Prithivi Vayur Akasham Apo Jyotishcha Raghava. He is referring to these five elements. Prithivi Apastejo Vayur Akasha. These five elements. We cannot give up our nature. We have to abide by the rules. Swabhave Samyatishthanti Shashvatam Margam Ashritaha Shashvatam. Eternally, I have to be like that. Water has to be water. Otherwise, I will not be water. So I have to follow nature. Then tat svabhavo mamapyesha yad agadhopya aham aplavaha. Agadha, samudra, the ocean, the nature of samudra is, I have to be agadha. Agadha means very, very deep. Gadha. Gadha means a sort of shallow land. Agadha means where there is no shallow land. Agadha is something which is so deep. So, agadho aham aplavaha. Vikarastu bhaved gadha yetatte pravadamyaham. And if at all there is some shallow land, it is actually not my nature. Then, na kamatana lobhadvana bhayat parthivatmaja. I cannot deviate from my nature for any reason. Even if you threaten me, even if you shoot brahmastra, whatever you do, I cannot deviate from my nature. This is nature. Wind has to be wind, air has to, fire has to be fire, water has to be water, earth has to be earth. Then he says, vidhasyayena gantasi visahishyepyaham tatha. But I will tell you a plan as to how you can do. And nagraha vidhamishyanti yavat sena tarishyati. I will also see, ensure such a way in which all these water beings, they will not die, all these lokas, whatever dhanavas, etc., they will all survive. And also, I will also retain my nature. But at the same time, I will give you some shallow space. So maybe, we do not know how that happened. So Samudra gives some sort of shallow space. That means, Samudra also, when you go down and down and down, there is some hard space. So probably there is some sort of realignment of some land, which a land mass which is there in this ocean. And some sort of shallow place emerged, some sort of shallow place. And in that shallow water, these people, they have to now build a bridge. They have to build a bridge means they have to fill it up. They have to fill it up and then they have to bring it up to the ground level and then only they have to move. So that is what he is suggesting. Then Harinam Tarane Rama Karishyametha Sthalam. I'll create some little bit of shallow place in me so that the entire area will not be agadha. Agadha means so totally deep. Some shallow place I will give. Then Tamabravid Tada Rama Shrunume Varunalaya Amoghostra Mahabana. Then when ocean god suggested that. Meanwhile, Rama is still having that Brahmastra. We have seen earlier also, Rama was saying Brahmastra cannot go futile. It has to be left. Brahmastra, earlier if you recall the episode of, in that Sundarakanda, there was an episode. Sita was telling an episode about how Rama took out one darbha reed and he recited that Brahmastra and then threw it on that crow, which came and kept on pecking Sita. That is the episode in which gods were trying to test the resolve of Rama. If you recall that episode. So there also he said, this Brahmastra cannot go waste, it cannot go futile. Now he is also saying the same thing, this Brahmastra cannot go futile. You tell me on whom I shall release. Now there is an interesting thing. Uttarena avakashvasti kaschit punyataro mama. Oh my dear, oh Rama. In the northern area, that is in the northern part of the ocean, there are some thieves. Drumakulya iti khyataha. That place, of course, he says, Drumakulya. We don't know what is that place. Loke khyato yatha bhavan. Ugra darshanakarmano bahavastatra dasyavaha. There are a lot many cruel thieves. They are all thieves in the ocean. Thieves in the ocean means they are all the pirates. Probably it is an interesting thing to see that even in those days, Ramayana times, there were some pirates. That means some boats are going and some other people, they come by boats and then they attack the boats and then they plunder. In fact, many the Western nations, they got lot of wealth like that. They got a lot of wealth by plundering. In fact, pirates, the history of pirates, if we see, it is very interesting. So many of these people who were here treated as heroes in the Western countries, it may be England or some other country, they were known for this, they were great pirates. So anyway, Ugra darshana karmano bahavastatra dasyavaha abhira pramukha papa pibandi salilam mama. All these sinners, they are all enjoying my waters. So these are the people who are there, they are plundering, they are the dasyavaha, they are the people who are robbers, that is pirates. Robber means the modern word is pirate. Then sea robbers. Then I don't even like to bear them. I am unable to bear them. I don't even like their sparsha. So you please hit them. So Rama left the arrow and then this arrow went and it is said to have destroyed those pirates. So anyway, then Rama released the arrow. It hit that area and that area became a small deserted area. Then again after all that episode was over, ocean god again spoke to Rama. Ocean god again, he has not left. Ocean god, he spoke to Rama. Ayam saumya nalonama tanayo vishvakarmanaha. We know that among all these vanara chiefs, they are all descendants of gods only. They are all sons of gods only. When Vishnu took avatara as Rama, Lashmana, Bharata, Shatrughna, Then what happened? Brahma suggested to all other gods, Indra, sun god, Agni, Varuna, etc., all these people. He suggested, okay, you also produce children through this Hari Ruksha. Hari Ruksha means through Vanaras and then Bhalluka, that is Bhalu. Bhalu is a bear. So through Vanaras and bears, you also produce children. So probably those gods, they had to produce some Vanaras, they had to produce some bears. So we had to visualize. So we should not think that that fair looking god has to produce children through some Vanara woman, etc. Gods, they have no shape. God is only a divinity, that power of the divine, that is what we have to see. We should not visualize him as some human beings only. And anyway, so all these people, they are all children of those divinities. So then what happened? There is somebody who is the son of Indra. We know that son of Indra was Vali. Then again, that son of Surya is this Sugriva himself. Then again, son of Vayu is Hanuman, we know. So similarly, son of Vishwakarma. Vishwakarma is the architect of gods. Vishwakarma is, we know that he is the architect of gods. He is the man who builds this Sabha for Indra, Sabha for somebody else, Sabha for somebody else, etc. So he is the architect of gods. His son is a person. In this particular army, there is a person called Nala. So he is the divine engineer, let us say, engineer in chief. So now this Nala is going to be the engineer in chief who is going to build this Nala Setu. So it is not Rama Setu, Valmiki calls it Nala Setu. Valmiki, for some reason, he has not called it Rama. We are going to see that also. So Ayam Saumya, Nalo Nama Tanayu Vishwakarmana. He is the son of that Vishwakarma. And Pitra Dattavara Shriman Pritiman Vishwakarmana. And the father has blessed him and he has given him all his powers. What all powers that Vishwakarma has, what all intelligence and what all technique that Vishwakarma has, all the technique is in this person. That is, Tamaham Dharayishyami Yathahyesha Pita Tatha. So let this Nala build a bridge over me. That I will hold. There is no problem. I will hold that bridge. Then wind god, this ocean god told it and he disappeared. Antardhanam we say. Ocean god eva muktva udathir nashtaha means he disappeared. And samuttaya nalastataha. Then Nala got up. All the while this person was just keeping quiet. He could have told. We don't know why he did not tell. So then he said, aham setuh karishyami vistirne makaralaye. Yes, I am going to build that setu. Pitus samarthyam asadhya tatvamasya tatvamaha mahodati. Pitus samarthyam asadhya. Then I have got all the powers of my father. And ayam hi sagaro bhimaha setu karma didrukshaya dadau dandabhayad gadham raghavaya mahodati. This samudra, this ocean god, because of fear of Rama, he has now provided a shallow place. So we have to visualize how, we don't know how Samudra ocean god provided that shallow place. So he provided some sort of shallow line, let us say, some sort of shallow line under the ocean. So now that has to be filled up by this Nala. Then Nala is still saying, Mama Maturu Varvodatto Mandare Vishwakarmana Mayatu Sadrushah Putraha Tava Devi Bhavishyati. So this Vishwakarma, this architect of gods, this engineer in chief, he has given some varam to my mother. Okay, my matsadrushaha, that is a son equal to me will be born to you. So I am equal to that Vishwakarma. Then aurasastasya putroham, I am that aurasaputra. Then smarutosmiyaham etena tatvamaha mahodadihi. Now I remember smaritosmi. Now probably we have to understand it that way. Smaritosmi means I am now reminded of it. That means all the while, probably he was also not aware, we do not know. But at the same time, he is also saying, Nachapyaham anuktovah prabruyam atmano gunan. In the very next line, he is also saying, I have been reminded by Samudra, first line he says. Then he also says, it is not proper for me to tell about my own gunas. It is not proper for me to tell about my own capabilities, so I kept quiet. So this is something which is contradicting, or we can understand it this way. The moment Samudra appeared, then probably this man Nala recalled his virtues. Then he immediately did not jump up. till Samudra God, he himself said, okay, you employ him, etc., etc. Then he probably kept quiet till that time. So we can understand that way. Nachapyaham anuktovah. It was not proper for me to tell about my own virtues, so I just kept quiet. So anyway, Rama deployed all these vanaras. They just jumped out, and then Haripungavaha utpetatuhu means they just in 1 minute they just jumped all over and then plucked out all trees and then brought huge mighty cliffs. Brought mighty, what is this? Nagasankashaha. Then Naga is hill. Nagasankasha, huge cliffs of hills, pluck out a huge stone and then bring it. So like that they brought all those things. And also huge trees, taihi salaihi. Then dhavaihi, vamshaischa vanara. So many trees, all types of trees, etc. They plucked out and then they brought. Then again, the parvatansha samutpatya. Even parvata means a mountain. They also shook those mountains and then brought them. Yantraihi parivahanticha. Some sort of yantras. Yantra means some sort of machines. They probably improvised. They improvised some yantras. Maybe probably to drag huge things, huge stones, etc. They improvised something. And then they brought all those things. Then prakshipyamanaihi achalaihi sahasa jalamudhrutam. Then and all these people, they just started putting it into the ocean. And this meanwhile, Nala also, he prepared people to hold huge rods, measuring rods. Dandan anye pargrunhanti. Danda means long rods for measuring or maybe to for various purposes. If you see the engineers, they will be carrying nowadays there is a huge tape. In those days, sutranyanye pragruhyanti. Sutram means a thread. So in olden days they carried a thread. Now of course we have got a tape. Now beautiful tapes have come. But before tapes came into existence, we used to have some Gunter's chain as we have that in order to measure the land. And similarly, they had some threads. So some people were carrying these ropes and some people were carrying these measuring rods, etc. And dandanyanye pargurundhanti vichinvanti tathapare. And some other people were bringing, some people were managing, and some people were putting it in proper shape and putting it in a proper straight line. So because when this bridge has to be built, it has to be built in a straight line. So that is the reason why they were carrying all these ropes and danda, that is long sticks. Then like that, it goes on, the description for that. Here of course we don't see that all these stones are floating on the water. We don't see. Normally in Ramayana stories we see that okay, they bring all the stones are brought, somebody writes the name Rama, and then write the name of Rama, throw it, and then it floats. And write the name of Rama, it floats. And meanwhile one squirrel also comes, and then that also dips itself into water, comes out, then rolls in the sand, and again goes out and shakes off that sand. So that a squirrel trying to help Rama, all that story is not there in Valmiki. Valmiki we find is so natural. Valmiki doesn't, we don't have that episode of a squirrel. And Rama kindly taking that squirrel and then just slightly gently stroking it. And because Rama stroked it, there are two lines on the back of a squirrel. So all these stories we have, we don't have that story in Ramayana. And we don't see that these huge boulders were floating on the ocean. Boulders, they naturally went. Naturally, it went into the water. Because Samudra himself said, I can't deviate from my nature. My nature is like that, I can't deviate from my nature. So when some hard thing falls into water, it has to sink. Naturally, it has to sink. So what all Samudra did was to provide some sort of shallow space. Or probably there was already some shallow space which he indicated. We are not sure. But that is what he followed the laws of nature anyway. So then, aham truti, then again they built like that. Then on the first day itself, they built about 14 yojanas. And again on the second day, again some 20 yojanas. Because this is such a mighty army, there is no shortage of stones, there is no shortage of trees. They're just plucking and then putting there. So like that, they go on building that bridge. And by the fifth day, that bridge was completed. So let us continue it tomorrow. Harihi Om Tat Sat.